Good morning, everyone, and welcome to another video. Slightly different this time, yeah, because I'm starting to come out of the closet and show you guys my lures. And I do have a slight addiction still for my lure fishing. And usually when the winter comes, I start to dust them off, and they become my main type of fishing. I do love fly fishing, and sorry for you fly guys, but I did put a video last time, and it was a good response from you guys for the support of me showing some lures. I know some of you still fish lures, and it might attract some new subscriber to the channel and make it grow a little bit more. By the way, thank you very much for the latest guys that joined. We are definitely growing all the time, and it's nice to see. So if you're new to the channel, welcome, and click on that subscribe button, and like and share and all that rest. So yeah, today I'm going to talk about different types of lures. Throughout this whole series, we're going to talk about all the lures that I use. I'm going to show you every lures that I use, the one that I like the most, the one that I'm going to try, what I believe in. And remember that this is purely for what I do here in Ireland, so it might not be the case for you. It's the case for me, so we might take inspiration out of that. So yes, what I'm going to talk today, it's what you may call the high-sided or flat-sided crankbaits. They're not necessarily for cranking. Some of them are really good in a retrieve and hard jerk and twitch response. They work really well like that. But the idea behind these lures, and why did I get them? Because of course you cannot find them, or very difficult to find them in Europe. They're all American lures used mostly for muskies, and they catch a ton of pike as well. The original designs, the grandmas, these ones. This is a 23 centimeter. The original design, these lures I've been catching way before I was born. And I think they came out in the 60s, the first ones. They were made out of wood. Now they're a lot more resilient. They're made out of a high impact plastic. The lip has changed over the years a little bit as well. It's made as well as from a really high impact plastic, because where they fish them across the pond, they hit rock a lot of time. They have a different structure of lakes than we have here. I'm not too worried about hitting rocks here, but over there, so yeah, they hit a lot of rocks, so that lip is really, really strong. It's not going to break too easily. By the way, I really do dig the new holographic ones. This is the brown trout one. These are, let me see that right, 23 centimeters for 84 grams. So on a modern rod now, and a bait caster, you can cast these no problem and reel them in, and they work really well. Jerking them and pause, and jerking them and pause. So the idea behind all this, why did I get them here? I like always to evolve in my lure fishing and change, because sometimes I get bored with the type of lure, so I try to find something different, a bit like my fly fishing. That's why all my flies never look the same, because I always like to catch pike on something different. So for me, locally here, I mean, everybody that has a boat that goes on the lake in the wintertime, everybody that has a boat has a line through trout, and they work. I mean, I've been using them since they came out, and it's a fantastic lure. But I think some of the fish, and some of the bigger fish, I've seen a little bit too many of them, and I start to have a feeling maybe the bigger, more clever fish, because this is what I look for. It's not quantities, it's quality in wintertime. So I want to find, like, I want to fool the biggest fish and the wisest fish usually, because the bigger they are, the wiser they are. That's what I always find out. They don't get that big by chance and by luck. It's usually because they have a little IQ, a little bit more than the one that won't make to that size. So the idea behind the flat-sided crank is that because they are so high and flat. Now this one will be used purely for trawling. This is another granny. This one is 33 centimeters for 156 grams. So they're not that heavy. The idea behind them is that they have a really wide move, and they push a lot of water from that high back. And what's happening is that the pike with their lateral line will feel these lures from a long way away. Curious to see the reaction with pikes here. I knew a guy that used to fish them years ago here, and he was getting some really clunking fish on that size. So rest in peace now, because that poor lad is dead now. But I remember he used to troll that in the, I think in the 90s I've seen him, and he was having some good success. So I got my hands on those. So this is the big grandma. This is the 33 centimeters. And then we have the smaller one. So this is the 23 centimeters. There is another brand of lure. I think they come from Musky Mania in the States as well. And I think they're the two main dominant design in the States. It's the Grandma Lure and the Jake from, I think it is Musky Mania, if I do my homework right. Musky Mania, they work out at 25 centimeter. They're hollow. All these lures are silent as well. I feel sometimes having two loud lures on wise fish. They've heard this clicking sound a little bit too much. So this is nice that those ones and the grandmas are silent as well, because they push so much water, and they move so much when you, especially if you troll them, that you don't need a rattle in those. So these are the Jakes, different colors as well. I really like them. A little bit heavier than the grandma, because the grandma are 84 grams, this one's 112 grams. The only main difference between these two is that the grandma would have a tighter roll. It would have a little bit a tighter waist like this than the Jake will have a much wider one. That's the only difference between the two. I'll have to see when I'll be using them. I suspect probably when it's kind of a wavy day, windy day. I think they move so much water that with the disturbance created by the waves and all that, they'll be they would emit a good call to the pikes, and they would come up to take them. So that's the hope behind it. I will be doing some casting as well, because cast and retrieve these ones, they do work as well. Like, so different lures, just something different. I wanted to try them. I've been a long time I wanted to do a gilf. Pardon the humor. It is a granny, and I like to fish grannies. So definitely gilfs. So yeah, that's about it. That's what I wanted to talk to you and show you. So we start by the flat-sided crankbait. And next video, I will show you something pretty special, because those are the new... Well, I've been using them for about 2-3 years. And the more I'm using them, the more I'm getting into them. And it's starting to overeat a little bit of my time and passion, but it's really a different type of lure that I really appreciate. That'll be coming in the next video, so stay tuned for that. So if you have any question about the grannies or the Jakes, put them in the comment section below. I'll see you very soon for the next video. Thanks for watching, thanks for the support, thanks for appreciating the change between the fly and the lures, but that's what I do. So expect a few more videos about lure fishing. So thank you very much, guys, and I'll catch you for the next one. Bye.